Hey guys, it's Melanie. Happy Thursday. So today I have another candle review for you guys. This is going to be my review of Yankee Candle's Brandy Pear Tarte. I have a ton of new candle reviews coming out over the next couple of weeks because I recently purchased a pretty decent influx of fall candles. So I wanted to make sure to get these reviews out early enough so that those of you who are starting to get into fall mode over the next couple of weeks have a sense of what's awesome and what maybe isn't so awesome. So Brandy Pear Tarte is actually an online exclusive for Yankee Candle this year. I don't know if they normally do that or if that is something new to Yankee Candle. I honestly haven't paid much attention to it in the past. So I actually purchased this one in store because I had a $10 off coupon from the semi-annual sale. You can't use those Yankee Cash coupons online, but when you go in store, you can actually order from online and they'll ship it to you for free, either to your house or to your local store. So I decided to go ahead and take the plunge on this one despite never having smelled it before. I had a feeling based on the description that I would really like it, and so I took a chance. Now, there have been quite a few reviews on this candle that haven't been all that great, and so I had actually thought about not burning it and just returning it, but I'm really glad that I took a chance and decided to light it. This is my second burn of this candle, and just so you guys know, how I do my candle reviews is I give you guys the initial review after usually the second or third burn, and then I will update you on how the candle does in my empties. So you guys will eventually get an update on how it did the whole way through. Okay, so the description here. From the online description, it reads, "The rich scent of baked pear in a sugary confection with a hint of brandy, a delicious reminder of your favorite cafe pastries." So the picture on it definitely looks very inviting and delicious. You see basically just like a little pear tart. When I first lit this, I was honestly most impressed with the speed at which this candle has pulled out for me. Both the first and the second burn, it pulled within about 45 minutes. And normally with a lot of my Yankees, it takes me like an hour to an hour and a half to get a full pull. And I normally also don't get as deep of a wax pool as you see right here. So this wax pool is a nice solid half inch, and I haven't foiled this or anything. The only thing that I've done is put the Aluma lid on, and I gotta say, with all of the fall candles that I've picked up so far, they have had a really great clean burn, and they've pulled out much faster than any of my other previous Yankee candles. When your candle pulls out faster and you get that nice wax pull there, you get more throw. Provided there's a good amount of fragrance oil in the candle, obviously. I happen to get a total winner here. I've heard so many people say that they could not smell a thing from their Brandy Pear Tarte. Mine is so strong, you guys. I actually have it in my office here, and I can smell it throughout the entire upstairs of my house. Like, one, that's usually unheard of with Yankee candles. And two, that's usually completely unheard of with Yankee candles. Like, it just doesn't normally happen. So I don't know if I have just gotten extremely lucky. It sounds like I might have, because like I said, other people have said they could not smell this candle at all. Now, mine smelled really strong on cold sniff. Like, when I picked it up at the store, it definitely had like a really strong fragrance to it from just like opening it and smelling it. And I also noticed that there was some pretty good marbling on this one. You can kind of see it like throughout the bottom here, but there was also a really good amount at the top here, which is now kind of like melted a little bit. But really, really good marbling on this one. And it, in terms of throw, I would say this is like a good solid 8. Like, And I'm shocked to say that, like I said, based on other people's reviews, but this is a good solid 8 for me. The strength of the candle is about like 7, 7.5. So it's doing extremely well. The overall appeal of the candle is fantastic, you guys. It honestly smells like a fall pastry type of candle. You get that really nice like fall, like spice note coming through. It's not too much cinnamon, it's not too much sugar, it's not too much nutmeg. It's just kind of a little bit of each of those. You get that buttery, flaky crust, and then you also get that beautiful, like, soft pear note. I don't normally love pear scents. I prefer apple over pear, but this also has a hint of apple in it, which is why I think it kind of tones down that pear note a little bit, and it's really lovely. It honestly, to me, is somewhat similar, not exactly the same, but somewhat similar to, now I'm going to like totally blank on the name, the Tarte Tatin. Hopefully I'm saying that right. I've done a review of that candle. Now that was a European exclusive, but I found it at my outlet. I will link that review down below. They're both actually pretty similar. I don't get any brandy at all from this. I was hoping to, maybe, because I figured that would be something a little bit different for me, but I don't get that. It smells like a straight up fall pastry, like bakery type candle. It's amazing. I'm tempted to buy another one, but honestly, I would be afraid that I would get a dud. But it smells so good, you guys. I know people have had better luck with the Tarts, so that might be the way to go. I will, of course, list this candle down below for you, and I will also list the Tarts, because that may be a really, really good way to start. This is totally worth a try for me, and I'm so glad that I took a chance on it despite some of the other reviews that are out there. When I looked at the reviews on the website, it's actually gotten fantastic reviews. There aren't a ton, but the reviews that it has gotten have said that it's just a really nice, you know, relaxing fall type of scent. So I have to agree with them, and I gotta say, I'm glad I took a chance. It smells great, you guys. I think if you really want to try the scent, maybe try it in a Tarte or in a smaller candle. If you can get, like, you know, a lot of times they'll do like the $10 add-on candle in the medium size with certain orders over like a certain amount. So I think it's definitely worth giving a try. And I would maybe suggest going to the store and seeing about having them ship it to you so you don't have to pay the $5.99 shipping. So anyway, let me know if you guys have any questions down below. But for me, this is 2 thumbs up, and oh, I love it. I honestly can't wait to like keep burning it. As I'm doing these reviews for you guys, I'm actually putting these candles away because it is still like, what is it? Like not even the middle of August, and it's so hot where I'm at. Like it doesn't even feel right burning these candles, but I'm loving kind of getting like that initial taste of fall, and it just makes me want it that much more. So anyway, thanks again, you guys, for watching. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and if you normally just watch my beauty videos, don't worry, those are still gonna be around. I'm just trying to get a lot of like these fall reviews out to you guys. So thanks a lot, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye bye.